this tutorial, we will see how to read physical analog input and write physical digital output. In fact, probably you noticed that in this project we didn't place blocks, function block that reads input and writes output, like in one tool with the block analog input conf and the out. In fact, according to the new workflow introduced with C Suite, the binding of the variables with a physical I/O is not done here in the strategy, but in with another tool called CDesign. We can start CDesign from here, from the tools, open CDesign. CDesign, you can see that is a wizard, so we entered straight to the second step, but there is also a first step that is simply a welcome. In the second step, we have to select the solution containing the project that we want to configure. You can see that the solution is already the right one. In fact, when we when we call CDesign from CStrategy, they can exchange each other the path of the solution. While in case you start CDesign from standalone, in that case you have to browse and select the solution file, that is the OTSLN file. Here there are some information regarding the solution, but you can set them also here in CStrategy. Let's go to the next step, and here we can create a configuration. What is a configuration? First of all, I will give a name, just to make a real example, chiller for compressors. Here we can select the hardware we wanted to use, CPIC or CPIC Mini. Also in this case you can see that there is a difference compared to one tool, because in one tool the hardware is chosen when you create the solution, while in C Suite is in a second step, that is this one. Okay, it is a configuration. I will create also another one, chiller to compressors. So what is a configuration? It's more clear if we go to the next step. A configuration is a collection of sub-configuration regarding the input and output protocols, default values, mask wizard, and so on. So in our example we could have two configuration for a chiller to compressor and chiller for compressors, with a different configuration, for example, of protocols, of different configuration of the default value. The chiller for compressors, the number of compressors is 4 and the other 2, and so on. Okay, in this exercise we are talking about input and output, so let's open the I/O editor. So we have a preview of the controller we have selected, and highlighted in blue are the sensible area corresponding the input and the output. So what do we have to do here? We have to double click. I try to zoom. Okay, now it's more clear. Double click the I/O you want to configure, so we can start from U1, Universal Input 1. We have to select the channel direction, because I have selected a universal channel. As told in the introduction, universal channel can be analog input or analog output or digital input in different models. So in this case we need of an analog input. The type NTC, PT 1000, voltage or current sensor. Okay, let's suppose to use a chip NTC sensor. There are other variables regarding the alarms, the probe alarm, and the field intensity. Okay, second one is the same of one tool, but let's focus to the first line, that is the variable. So here we can bind a given variable of the application with a given input, physical input or physical output of the controller. So I have to click, browse and select the variable. And where are the variables? So this list is empty because we have to select here in the global variables, not only the global variables but also somewhere else that we will see later, we have to select the variables that we want to make visible in the other editors. The editors are the IO editor, that is the one that we are using now, and then protocol, user interface, default, and so on. So we have to check this. I can't modify, why? Because I am still in simulation. So stop this ones and also compressor 1, 2, 3, 4. So all the variables that have the check here can be used and visible in the IO editor. Well, now I have to build . Now I can continue, go back to the IO editor, select again the variables, and here is our variable. We can see that in this list you can use only real variables for the analog input. Well, so the U1 terminal is bound with the water inlet temperature of the application. Now let's go in the other side for the compressor number 1, 2, 3, 4 connected to the digital output 1, 2, 3 and 4. Double click, direction is the out, also because this is not configurable. Channel type standard, ok, the alternative are relay with a sort of PWM, but for now we need standard the out. The variable is the compressor 1. For the second relay, the variable compressor 2, ok, relay 3, compressor 3, relay 4, compressor 4. Well, that's all for what we need for this exercise. The other buttons are used just to create a screenshot of the controller, to print, to fit to the Windows. Very convenient is this button to switch from a graphical view, that is this one, to a table view like this. Someone may prefer a table view like this. Now I want to introduce an important concept, the concept of the repository. But the point is, if you remember in the introduction I told you that the editors are independent, so the C strategy is independent from C design, and the same for the other editor, C Factory and C Mask. So how can they communicate each other, for example the variables that the application uses? The editor, let's say, communicates through a common repository. The repository is a database, is a file, where C-strategy reads and writes the files. Proprio in this case, we can see that the strategy writes the binary file, so when you build, it writes the binary file here, as well as it writes the variables created in the global variables windows, as well as the flags, like the one that I just used, the IO flag. So when you run another editor, for example C Design, he can know what are the variables that he can use, reading them in the repository, reading the list of the variables. As output, it writes the configurations. Remember, chiller to compressor and chiller for compressor that I had created before. I told you that you can start these editors standalone from the start menu here, as well as from the C strategy. So in case you start the editor standalone, the first thing that we have to do is select the repository correspondent to the project you want to manage. On the other side, when you start them from C strategy, in this case C strategy communicates to the editor the path of the solution and so also the path of the repository, so it's not necessary to select the repository. This is what we have done just before. Well, also for this tutorial it's all. In the next tutorial we will see how to create a simple user interface using the Mask Wizard.